Dear friends, welcome back. This is Nick from educates.tv and today we are going to see how to develop this real-time clock and temperature monitor. Let's get started. A few weeks ago, I tested this 3.2-inch color TFT display for Arduino with both the Arduino Mega and Due. The display works fine and I built a simple project with it. It is a temperature monitor and a real-time clock. As you can see at the top, we can see the current date and time. We can see the temperature right now, and at the bottom, the Arduino records the minimum and the maximum temperature that it has measured. I also tried to design a basic user interface just with simple shapes. As you can see, everything works fine and it is a very easy and useful project to build. Let's see how to do it. The parts needed in order to build this project are these: an Arduino Due or a Mega, a 3.2-inch color TFT display, a DS3231 Real Time Clock module and some male heaters. The cost of the project is around $24. You need around $14 for the Arduino Due, $8 for the display, and about $2 for the RTC module. You can find links for all the parts in the description of the video. I am going to use the Arduino Due to build this project, although I could use the slightly cheaper but slower Arduino Mega. Arduino Due is much faster than the Arduino Mega and it has a lot of memory, that's why I prefer it for this project. At first, we have to connect all the parts together. I am going to use these male heaters in order to connect the real-time clock module to the Arduino Due. We need 4 heater pins, 2 for power and 2 for the I2C interface. We bend them like this and we connect one to the 3.3V of the Arduino Due board, the other to ground and the other two to SDA and SEL pins of the board. With some female wires, we connect the module to the board. That's it. Now we can attach the display to the board. You don't have to connect these two pins to the Arduino board, so I will leave them floating. Now we are ready to power up the project. As you can see, it works fine. It's that easy. Let's now go to the computer to see the software side of the project. The code of the project is built using the UTFT library, so it will work with other displays as well. Unfortunately, the display we're using is not supported directly from the UTFT library. In order to use this display with the UTFT library, we have to use a modified version of the library, which comes from the designer of the display. Unfortunately, I cannot share it with you because it is forbidden by the library's terms. So you have to download the library from banggood.com or from the shop you purchased the display. Except from the basic program file, we also need 2 font files in order the code to work. Just copy and paste these 2 font files in your project's folder. We need Grotesque 16x32 and Grotesque 32x64. You can find links for these fonts in the description of the video. Now we are ready to take a look at the code. The first thing we have to do is to set the time to the real-time clock module if it is not already set. In order to do it, enter the current date and time in this line of code, uncomment this line of code here and upload the program to Arduino. Now the time is set, but then we have to comment this line of code again and upload the program to Arduino once more. As you can see, the code of the project is simple. We just print the user interface and then display the date, the time, and the temperature on it. I have also prepared a version of the code with the temperature displayed in degrees Fahrenheit. You can find the code in a link in the description of the video. As you can see, with a few lines of code and with very low cost, we can build a very useful project. I am going to work more on this project since it will become an advanced weather station with more sensors, graphs and Wi-Fi capabilities. Since the Arduino Due is very fast and has a ton of memory, I think it is the ideal Arduino board to use. What do you think about this project? How do you want to see it evolve? Please post your comments or ideas in the comment section below. If you are new to the channel, you may not know that my day job is developing Android games, and 4 months ago I published a new game on Google Play Store. It is called Quiz of Knowledge and it is a quiz game that supports 5 languages and it is completely free. If you like quiz games, I am sure you are going to enjoy this one. If you wish, you can download it by clicking here or in a link in the description of the video. Thanks! If this is your first time here, I would love to have you subscribed. In this channel, I post videos about do-it-yourself projects every Saturday. I love making things and I believe that anyone can make things. Anyone can become a maker. That's why I created this channel in order to share my knowledge with the community and learn from the community. I hope you will join us. Until next Saturday, watch, learn, build.